What's going on, guys? We're here today, and today we're going to be reacting to The Lover's Stone, Episode 3, Memories. Well, the last one was kind of a little bit more informative on what exactly is going on with Discord. We also learned Celestia may know exactly what's going on with Discord, that when she froze him in stone for the first time, basically the Elements of Harmony may have left a little mark on him, and it may have caused a little too much of a, like, something that would happen if he was released in stone again. He'd basically be slowly killed over time, or maybe frozen in stone again. This is a very interesting series. I really like the take on this. Now, that's the whole part with Celestia and all that. They have also got two new ponies. I can't remember their names at the moment. I think it's Scarlet and Crap. I can't remember her name. But basically, they've got two helpers who kind of know what they're doing. I like that they interpreted the, you know, Crystal Empire. The universe is taken as totally alternative because it doesn't match any of the timelines with the show. but it's going to get interesting real quickly. So, what's going to happen to Discord? I have no idea. But in this one, just judging by the name, I think we're going to find out a little bit more about Celestia and Discord's past. I can't recall if Celestia said this bluntly. Like, I don't know if she said that she was the cause of his chaotic side. Like, why he went like chaotic in the first place and she had to basically put him in timeout for how many years? Like, 1,000 years or something like that. I can't remember the exact date. Or the exact number. Basically, I have a feeling we're going to learn a little bit more about that. So, we're going to be getting some backstories. So, without further ado, let's just jump into this. I'm really enjoying this series, and even though I'm not really a Celestia Chord shipper, I kind of like it. And I know this, you know, series is not doing the best, but hey, it's something to react to, it's something to have fun with. Oh, and I forgot to mention this. I can't believe I almost forgot this. Merry Christmas and Happy Holidays to all. You guys are amazing. I hope you're fantastic. I hope your Christmas was fantastic or heartwarming, whatever you want to call it. Hope you had a great time with your families, got great gifts, had great Christmas dinner. No matter what happened, I hope you guys had a fantastic day, fantastic holiday, and yeah, onward to 2019. My Christmas was pretty basic. At least the day spared me and I didn't have to shovel snow. So anyways, enough of that. Let's just get into this. I am expecting to learn a lot more about Celestia and Discord's past. So, without further ado, let's just do this. 3, 2, 1, go. I have no idea how loud that is. So far, the voice acting and everything in this is really good. I think the volume's up all the way. Let me turn it down just a little bit. Yeah, that should do it. Again, I apologize, I cannot say this VA's name. Akira Okamiden? Okamaden? I don't know. I apologize heavily. Your voice acting is great so far. The only site that I really don't know much about is Luna. She has a thing for the guard, but apparently she's a little overprotective of Celestia, and they need to take care of that. Like, Luna's trying to be some pony she's not supposed to be. She's trying to be too good, and in doing so, it's kind of, I don't know, changing her. Not in a good way, either. That's one thing I forgot to mention in the beginning. So, let's watch. Chapter 3 of The Lover's Stone. Looks like we're in stone.
Good feeling about these mares.
How can you be so sure they can fix this?
You just met them, and you already seem so sure. I can't help but have my doubts.
It's kind of part of his nature, Celestia.
If I give you hope, how come you didn't come to me about all this sooner?
I was scared of what this would do to you. We grew up together, and that's reason enough for you to be upset.
We grew up together, there you go. They have memories. Or not memories, they have a, like, you know, past.
Even I had my suspicions about this being caused by the elements. I turned on you, and you had to seal me in stone. Now I'm being consumed by the stone. I just knew
it's
you...
kind of ironic, honestly.
I don't want that for you.
I blame myself, because it is my fault!
Here we go.
If I had just listened to you or talked to you, I might not have sealed you in stone in the first place. None of this should have happened!
Zia, I was blinded and unreasonable back then. Trying to reason with me would have been useless. If you had listened to me, I would have hurt you and Luna. And I would never have forgiven myself if I had hurt you too. What you did was right. Don't ever blame yourself for my actions.
You didn't seal yourself in stone. I did.
You had good reason to.
No, I never did.
This is all my fault.
It's conflicting on both ends. Like, Discord thinks he still did something wrong, and Celestia is claiming that something...
You're now arriving at the Canterlot train station.
Is that KP?
Thank you for joining us today, and have fun in Canterlot!
It's gotta be KP. There's Derpy in the background, I think. Seriously, what is this? That looks like just a...
Yes, who's alive?
What do you call them? Like a transition.
Hello, sister.
Interesting.
So is it all sorted out now? Is he actually fine, like I said?
No.
Not quite. I am having the two mares come out here to try and find the cure. Of course.
Forgot that one's name.
Oh. All right, then. Luna? Is everything... Yes! Everything is fine, sister. I will handle everything here. You just go look after Discord. But Luna... It is fine, sister. Just go. Oh, right.
Okay.
We will leave you to it.
Sorry for the heater, guys.
Bob? What was that, Luna?
Bob?
Nothing.
Is that his name?
That didn't look like nothing to me, Luna.
Yeah.
You need not concern yourself with it, Bob.
I'm sorry, Princess, but
yeah,
I
Luna
do.
Is very, concerned.
Like I thought you got
She's thinking
this.
That Discord's not
I
fully
have.
Reformed.
No, you haven't.
And that he's
just
trying to trick... Celestia into
if
doing something.
You must know. When both me and Celestia were young, we both were very close to Discord. He was like a brother to us. And this was normal, for we had grown up in a small town. No other fillies were around.
Oh.
Sadly, due to our destiny to become princesses, we were forced to leave Discord behind. I didn't know at the time, but the two were in love.
They still are.
At such a young age?
Well, back then, Celestia would have been a young mare and I would have been a filly. It wasn't uncommon for the time either. When Discord came to us here in Equestria countless moons later, he was still in love with her. She wouldn't tell me, but I suspect she still loved him too. Because of her status as the beloved princess,
yeah.
She couldn't be with him.
But why not?
Because our people feared him. No pony was stronger than him except for Tia and I.
Well, that still doesn't excuse you for your behavior just now.
I know. But I'm just trying to protect my sister. I'm afraid of the consequences that may follow. If he really is sick, she will be devastated. If he's not, he will find a way to use her or hurt her.
She's more convinced. She's convinced about Celestia's well-being, pretty much.
We wouldn't know of it. Either way, it's not good. I didn't want them to get close again, but I fear it's too late.
I understand your concerns, but I ask you to please be kinder to your sister. She is having a tough time and is at risk of losing someone near to her. Whether it's real or not, she thinks
yeah.
It is. Don't make her feel like she's losing you too.
I understand. I just can't stand seeing her hurt.
If so, then give her as much support as you can. That will help to ease her pain.
You're right.
I will follow them and watch over your sister. Maybe this can help grant you some peace of mind. I will protect her, and I will always protect you.
Thank you.
My pleasure, Princess.
I can see this going in many directions. Okay, is that transition going to be there again? The thing that looks like it's in scales? Yes. What is your name?
Cantalot!
Quiet down, Scarlet.
Okay, Scarlet.
How many times will I have to tell you we are here for business, not sightseeing?
I know,
but it's just so exciting.
Sorry about that.
Do you even know how to get to the castle from here? Or have a map there?
Oh.
Go ask the train conductor.
All right.
Who voiced her? There was a misinterpretation. Yeah, it's KP. I had an misinterpretation with the voice actors. One sounded like Obab to me, but it wasn't.
Go left until you.
So that's not Obab. That's Anna. Is it Anna?
All right. Thank you.
Yeah, I think it's Anna. That voice is the one that's like very Britishy. The one that sounds like freaking Obab. Wow, these two are the lovely bunch. Again, interesting transition.
Hello, princess.
I don't know if that's an error or if that's
supposed
to be something that's just relevant.
All right. Sorry. Where will we be working?
In the Chaos Dimension.
I think that was Kate. I think that was
I'm afraid that's not
Kenzie in the background in that last pick.
Follow me.
Oh, come on!
Hey, that's Sweet Bell's line.
Not exactly.
Well, that's no fun.
That's no fun.
Do you think that they like each other?
Don't ask things like that. Right, sorry!
Yeah, who was that hanging from the ceiling?
Sorry.
Wow.
And why?
Do you like it? This will do quite well. We should get to work right away.
Where should we start?
We will need a sample of both this cord's natural form and a sample from the stone. Do you mind?
Oh.
The stone.
What does that do?
Oh, no worries. It shouldn't hurt.
Okay. Ouch. Ouch.
Did
oh,
he?
Goodness. Sorry about that.
Fine.
At least you won't have to do it again.
All right, that is all we should need for now.
Okay, now that sounds like Anna, but my god, it's like Obab in the last one.
All right, thank you, you two.
Like, just her natural voice.
Wait, one last thing. If his condition changes at all, come back to us immediately.
This is probably going to go in many directions. So we've got Bob following them to, like, inspect Celestia's safety. To ensure her safety.
We wait for them.
You want to come to my dimension?
And now they're working
Discord.
On a cure.
Ta-da.
Discord? What an equestrian. Oh,
what
gosh.
The
what
hell?
What on earth was that?
A piranha pickle. My favorite pet. Oh, what if he did some cheese?
What if he did some cheese?
No, thank you.
Fine.
Help me.
That's
Someone
double play.
Me. Who is that?
Some
weird pony I wanted as a pet.
I'm not weird, I'm just misunderstood. Let him go, Discord.
Fine.
How about we find something else to do? I mean, it's lovely here, but I don't want to get eaten by your, pets. Or, you know, become one of them.
We could go in my house and frost some cake.
What? No, let's just go back.
Something's up with Celestia here.
Fine.
Something that triggers the past.
Are you okay?
Yeah, I'm okay. What would you like to do?
What should we do? I don't want to put too much strain on his body while he's sick.
Yeah.
He's Discord.
How about we take a walk in the garden?
Sure.
Oh, romantic. Very romantic. Seriously, this transition, I don't know if that's an error or not. I don't think so. See, it wasn't in the last part or the previous part either.
When did this sickness start?
I'm not really sure.
I need to turn it up a little bit. I can't hear. God, that freaking heater's loud.
Does it hurt?
Sorry about that.
Sometimes, but never badly. It mostly makes me weak. When I get those attacks, it can hurt a bit, though.
Come with me. This is one of my favorite places here.
It's
and why would that be?
I used to come here and think about you and what I had done. Stealing you in stone.
Ship!
So,
fuck's sake.
It was horrible to think about when I was here. I think I might just... No.
Too serious!
Hey! Give that back!
Oh, you're gonna have to catch me, Celestia.
No, come back here! You are not eating my
Oh, does he got his... Oh my god, really?
It's my turn to catch it now, huh?
She's got...
Look,
he's got her tail.
Disco, why? Why?
Do I even have to say it?
Oh, am I interrupting something?
Bob.
No.
All right.
Couldn't you have given him a better name than Bob? Whatever, it's fine. I don't... Bob's just, like, your casual name. Ship! He stole her tail.
I'm gonna go and check on Gypsy and Scarlet.
Gypsy, that was her name. Kinda fits, in a way. So I'm a little confused right now. Who did what? Like, Discord's saying that she didn't do anything wrong.
Hello?
She's saying she did something
Celestia?
Wrong.
Celestia, what are you doing here? We just got started.
Literally.
Well, something juicy happened between you and Discord, didn't it? Oh, what,
yeah.
Scarlet? Hey, you were thinking it too. Well, nothing happened. We were just on a walk in the garden. All right, you got what you wanted. Now shush, Scarlet. Should set them up on a date or something. No, completely out of the question. Why not? I hate to give Scarlet your
funny.
View for her childish fantasies, but
that
I
was
have
one of the
to
best
agree.
Freaking arts
Why
I've
not?
Seen in this fandom. Absolutely not. Out of the question.
I stick with the real things, usually greeting
Kenzie. I didn't recognize the other two.
I minimize the unknown threat. Why? I help run a kingdom full of ponies and other like-minded creatures. How can I risk it by
distracting
about a day?
There we go. That's more even.
Equestria's fate. If I was to distract myself with a blinding love for some pony, how would I manifest that? Equestria might be taken control of.
This seems just like Dark Discord. Because Screwball and, what's his name? Mothball basically had to admit their love for each other to save the day. They refused it until the end. Same thing with the Bride of Discord, technically. Only in the end did they finally, you know, realize they loved each other. After so much turmoil. Do not recognize the song at all, but it's catchy.
I'm ready to. Celestia, don't you think you'll be a little, just a tad? I'm not defensive.
Tasty?
I'm simply being cautious. I can't risk reckless dating due to my miscalculating wife.
I bet that took multiple takes. Recognize all those OCs. I know the one is a Kenzie, but I don't recognize the other. I recognize the other two, but I don't know who they are.
Could end up with a horrible life. Sorry, girls, but
cause chaos across the world, then turn life upside down for us all. We would just fall to his will. He could have masterminded some way to trick me. He could be a liar.
So, Celestia is aware of the danger.
He could be less than kind, or even worse.
She is afraid of him being bad. Knows that he could be bad. Therefore, she's afraid to, you know, admit she's in love with someone who could possibly be, you know, using her. So Celestia's aware of everything that Luna's afraid of. Interesting. That was a long note. I don't know who's singing in Celestia. Excuse me. So I think I missed something at the beginning of the episode. Something to do with a stone. Which I'm guessing is the lover's stone.
Why can he only get close to her when my life is on the line?
Well,
I wish I could have gotten more time with her.
Okay. Uh-oh.
What is happening?
Good question.
No! Stop! No! That shouldn't happen!
Wait.
Why all of a sudden?
What is triggering this? There's something that's triggering it. Huh. Well, Discord's in trouble.
Celestia. Now I have to go back to Discord after the awkward situation from earlier.
Uh-huh.
Discord? I'm back. They haven't even started yet. Silly me. Discord? Discord! No! Discord! Discord! Wake up! Please! I need you.
What happened?
Oh, Discord, thank goodness!
Something's gotta be triggering
this.
I was sitting on the bench, waiting when, it started to move up my neck and down my arm. It stopped on its own, but I don't know what happened.
Discord, when did you last take the medicine Zecora gave you?
Good question.
Not since we were in the Empire.
Think you can stand?
I'll try.
Why don't you just hand feed it to him?
We have to get you over.
Or hoof feed it to him. Sorry, okay. Pony puns. Cause pony puns. Again, transition.
Jesse, Scarlet, help!
How did this happen?
You forgot to take the medicine. The stuff Zecora gave us. When I left, this happened to him.
This should help with the discomfort.
All right.
We will have to keep you here for a little while longer to ensure nothing else happens.
Okay.
It It appears to be a growth on the stone on your neck. I'll have to take another example to confirm this.
Oh, the stone off of his body. Okay, that makes more sense. Okay, thank you. Thank you, Gypsy, for confirming that.
Don't worry, Discord. We will find a way to fix this.
She sounds a lot like a mod.
Go ahead.
All right.
Can I step outside for a moment?
Sure.
Animation, nice. Sorry, it's late. Not mean to yawn and bored. I'm not bored at all. Would you just kiss already? I mean, seriously. Let me guess, he just gained the, courage to actually talk to Celestia, and now Celestia is going to basically let him go or something? It's a common cliche. Or is something going to go wrong and Bob's right there to see it and Luna's going to be informed that he may be doing something? Supportive.
For that. Your job isn't easy, nor is your life. I understand this now. Having to deal with two of the most important people in your life turning evil, it mustn't have been easy. But that
two
also means your judgment.
Never mind.
You knew the difference between
I caught
the
it. Luna and Discord. Makes sense.
Discord shouldn't be an exception. I realize now he is truly sick, and that he truly needs you. Luna.
Thank you, Luna.
I will do do whatever you need me to do in this time. Just ask. It's the least I can do for you after putting you through so much pain all those years ago.
Or wait, is Discord gonna cause her pain?
Dwell on the past too much. It's already gone, and things are different now. Stop blaming yourself for everything.
Thank you. Could you do me one favor?
Of course.
Take care of yourself through this too. I know it can't be easy doing both jobs.
In return, you must promise me one thing.
That's cute.
All right.
Quit lying to yourself about your true feelings from Discord.
I'm so sorry that I'm being quiet, but I want to capture everything. Normally I miss something.
She's right.
If I talk.
I am in love with Discord.
There you go. Acceptance. Alright, so now what's gonna happen? Is the question.
Felt good to actually accept this for what it is, didn't it?
Oh, shush you. But yep. Yes, it did. Thank you, Bob.
Bob.
So, what do we need to do right now?
Oh, no.
Our work?
No. We should take a break and maybe play some video games?
What game?
Are you kidding me?
Alright.
Phantom Luna? On. Really? The gamer? The gamer stereotype?
I'm taking it easy on you just because you're my guard.
Wouldn't have it any other way, princess.
Sorry, my mind goes to those places. I'm thinking other things than that. Wow, Discord, you're looking rough.
Do you think it will work?
I honestly don't know, but it's her best shot.
No, she sounds like Siri Polymer. Siri Polymer, that's the one that I'm looking for.
I will let you two speak.
Oh boy.
What is this all about?
We have a new plan.
Okay.
A plan on how to potentially fix me.
Okay.
You may not like it, though.
Oh dear.
But this is my choice, okay?
Just tell me already.
We are going to ask Twilight and our friends to retrieve the Elements of Harmony and attempt to cast a spell to strip my body of all remnants of the elements.
What?
Whoa. Okay, that's going a little too drastic, don't you think, Discord? Okay. Is that it? Yep. Right at the point when she was going to admit her feelings. Yep, that's the key to this. The love part of it is all part of the storyline. I honestly have no idea how long this is, but... it's up to episode 5, which is still in the works. Because Kenzie has just been having a terrible year as far as health problems go. Feel bad for the girl. I mean, I see her tweets all the time. She's got like all these tweets that are just saying that she's got all sorts of things going on. And I'm like, my god, poor girl. Minty Snowflake, PS Coldfire, Gypsy Heart is Kenzie, Scarlet, Anna, Train Conductor, I Love Impossible Life, yeah, makes sense. Discord's Pet was Double Play, yep. Kenzie does some of the art. I'm sorry if I missed that. Or I'm sorry if I missed that a lot. It's hard to really keep up with everything that's going on. You from Okami. Nope. Original song When He Sees Me from Waitress. Again, I have no idea. Broken, the original song I Know Those Eyes, This Man Is Dead from The Count of Monte Cristo. I know the name of, or I know of the excuse me, I know of that thing. It's a movie and a story, and it's all sorts of stuff. I mean, God knows how many covers of I Will Be There has been done on YouTube, especially by pony YouTubers. Sayoko? So, also the part on Luna's side has been resolved. So, now Discord's just trying to go like the easy route. I have a feeling that it's not gonna work that way. Celestia should have just admitted her love for him. But it's probably gonna be put off on hold now. And that sounds stupid, but yeah, that's probably exactly what's gonna happen. Alright, I can't even think right now. That was The Lover's Stone, Episode 3, Memories. Yeah, this is going to places. We've basically got a lot of Luna's side of things completely figured out and taken care of. Like, her whole ordeal was that she was being too harsh on Celestia for thinking that that Discord was a bad person because of past experiences. Apparently there's more in the past that we don't know about. Basically, they grew up with Discord, and Discord turned out to be a maniacal little crap. But there's still, I think, a little bit more behind that than meets the eye, because Discord is saying she didn't do anything wrong, but she's saying she caused it. What did she do exactly that she's blaming herself for? And did she actually do anything wrong? Honestly, was she too angry? Like, was she angry over everything or over something stupid and decided to put too much magic on him and it caused, like, a burst of something? Maybe she broke his heart. Maybe he broke her heart the first time. And, I don't know. It's really hard to determine what exactly is going on in the past here. But as for where this is going, yeah, the Elements of Harmony are probably doing that with the Elements of Harmony would probably just make it worse. Honestly, it probably would. So, this is going to start getting interesting because we're kind of getting into the more detailed parts of the story. This is going to be getting much more intriguing. It's just kind of started out slow, a little easy, and now it's heading into more of the bigger parts of the story. But love is the answer here. I can see it plain as day. It's kind of along the lines of, like, Daughter of Discord and Bride of Discord. I mean, think about it. In Daughter of Discord, Screwball and Mothball had to admit the love for each other in order to defeat Chrysalis. Well, actually, what they had to do is kiss. They already knew they loved each other. They kissed and Team Rocketed freaking Celestia back to wherever she belonged. Then there was Bride of Discord, where they basically admit their love for each other after denying it so long. Well, Discord, in the case of Bride of Discord, Discord never truly loved Fluttershy until he really got to know her and started to, you know, develop real feelings for her. Fluttershy was a little bit more in denial, like how Celestia was. Basically refuses to believe that she's in love with him, but eventually has to come to acceptance that she is in love with him. And that's pretty much exactly what is happening here. She knows that she's in love with him, which is good. Discord knows he's in love with Celestia. They just have to admit it to each other, and what happens then, I have no idea. But I think that's the solution to everything that is happening here. But then again, just like any other audio drama series like Remembrance, this could take turns quickly. Like, I have no idea how many episodes long this is. I don't know how long the story is. I don't know what extent the story goes to. It's going to be interesting. That's all I can say. And I'm sorry that this is not, you know, the most interesting thing to react to, but I was requested to react to it, and I'm actually really enjoying it. As for, you know, anything else, I really can't really debunk anything else at the moment that really is going to play into this. And yeah, that's basically all I gotta say on this one. So Merry Christmas, everybody, and hopefully you all had a fantastic holiday, or heartwarming, whatever you want to call it. And until next time, that's all for now. Like, comment, subscribe for more if you enjoyed this, and hit that bell icon to get notified about everything I do. I upload readings once a month, and I try to at least get one out per month. And I do reactions occasionally, because why not? So, anyways, that's all I've got for now, and Merry Christmas, Happy New Year to all of you, and until then, until the next time, happy horse until then, and take care.